out here in the pits at the NHRA, you know there's something about stockers because they're real cars, the actual car, pretty much the way they were built from the factory, just super fast. And there's some that look like stockers are you supposed to look like Craig Sauerbaugh's Chevy Nova, Chevy 2. Craig, this thing is awesome. When did you get your car?
Oh, I started racing this one in 1986.
So this is a mid-80s stocker. Is it a 66 or 67 Nova?
66.
66 Nova. Clutch car. It is absolutely beautiful. What made you want to get this one?
I thought it'd be a good combination for running stock with a stick shift. Originally it had the 283 and now I'm with the 327.
Been running since the 1980s. And just the whole look of it, to me, screams NHRA stock eliminator. The paint, the lettering. Tell us a little bit about how all that came to be.
I have a good friend that likes to do body work, and that's how we got the car fixed up. I'm more of a chassis and engine builder and such, you know. But I do work for him, and he does work for me.
They say it's a drag race, not a car show. But that's not true. People want to have a nice-looking car to represent them, and it seems like you've gone the extra mile.
Yep, and they did a really fantastic job on it.
And it has held up. Most importantly, this car has been painted like this since the 1980s.
Yes, that's what it was.
Can we see under the hood?
Sure.
All right, Craig Sauerbaugh, Chevy 2, 1966. Now we're going into your area of the race car. Tell us what's under the hood and what are we looking at?
It's a 327, and NHRA rates it at 274 horse. And Parsons and Myers did the motor for me. And Heads Up did the cylinder heads, and they got me a good motor. It's really competitive. I qualified like number four at the Baby Gators this year, so that was pretty good.
Yeah.
And today we're having a little traction problem. We took clutch out of it, and we'll see what happens on the next run.
Yeah, no automatic for you. You're a clutch guy. How did that start? Did anyone ever try to talk you into running an automatic?
Hundreds of people. My first Corvette stick, and I've had one ever since.
You are just a clutch guy. What I am liking, hopefully everybody can see, stockers retain so much from the factory, but the stuff that matters has been really refined. Just, can you tell, right? The average person might not notice. I see what you got going on here with your shocks. Obviously, the headers are beautiful, stainless headers. It's the factory taken to perfection.
Yes, that's what it is. Safety equipment's been updated, obviously, brakes and, you know, such, a good roll bar and, you know, special guts in the rear end, so it lasts, it takes the abuse.
What kind of reaction do you get to this car from people who are coming by, fans, they're out to see John Forrest, they see this car, probably had one when they were a kid?
A lot of people that like stockers really like it, because it's old, more or less old school, you know?
That's why we're here. That's the look. Can we see you in your office?
Sure.
All right. Craig Sauerbaugh. It really is. Like, this is what an old school stock eliminator car is supposed to look like. Well campaigned, West Michigan auto body. Look at Craig dive in there. All right, walk us through a run from burnout to making a run in this machine.
Okay, you get in it, you get in the water, you put it in second gear, and rev it up and dumb the clutch and get the tires to the proper temperature. Then you pull up to the line, you put it in first. I have a brake pressure gauge, so I know how much brake pressure I have. Turn on the computer, push the button so it starts to record the run. And then I go up and put it on the rev kill and take off.
Yeah, data acquisition, very important, even in classic stockers. You have to have that information.
Yep, that's right.
So I love it. I'm just so impressed. Obviously, you got the decals from all the events. 1986 Sportsman Cup. The paint has held up so well, Craig. Can we hear this thing run?
Sure.
All right, light it up. Here we go. F stock. Sauerbaugh, you can hear that overlap in the camshaft, man. The duration, that's where you make the power. It sounds so sweet. How much do you love this car?
I wouldn't trade it for anything. Maybe the Corvette.
Maybe. the Corvette. Craig, thank you very much for sharing your car with us.
Okay, thank you very much.
And that's why you come out into the pits here at the NHRA.